Whenever an act of sportsmanship plays out on the cricket field, the commentators jump onto the occasion to declare, "This is why cricket is called the gentleman's game." However, proper consideration for fairness, respect, and a sense of sportsmanship and fellowship with one's competitors is applicable for all other sports. Then how come only cricket is labeled as a gentleman's game? Although the first reference to cricket appeared in the 13th century, cricket was born in the British Isles in the 16th century, and since then it has spread to many parts of the world, mostly through British imperialism. It is one unique game in which players have to abide by what is called the spirit of the game, which is in addition to the laws of the game. The game gained popularity in the 17th century when English aristocrats started playing and patronizing the game as a form of enjoyment. They decided that cricket would be marketed as the gentleman's game. The Oxford Dictionary defines gentleman as a chivalrous, courteous, or honorable man. However, the gentleman in gentleman's game doesn't refer to any of these notions. The term refers to old landed gentry of England. They were landowners equivalent to Indian zamindar whose families hailed from the upper class. These people were referred to as gentlemen due to their income solely deriving from land ownership and their higher status in the British class system. In essence, the term defines cricket as a game of privileged few. As the colonial empire prospered, cricket became well established in the countries across the world, from the Caribbean to South Africa, India, Australia, and New Zealand. Soon, the game's popularity breached the class barrier and spread among the masses. But the disparity and the class division were an integral part of England's national sport, as cricketers were divided into gentlemen and players. The former were the amateurs, men generally from a privileged background who had gone to the best schools and then on to Oxford or Cambridge. Men with independent means who didn't need an income from the game they played for enjoyment. Players were the lesser cricketers, not because of any deficiency in talent, but because they came from the working class who had to work hard for their livelihoods when they are not playing cricket. They were professionals in an era where the term was pejorative, so they didn't have access to the gentlemen's better appointed dressing rooms. Not just that, they walked into the ground through a separate gate while the gentlemen walked out through another reserved for them. At the time, cricket was ruled by aristocrats and they were against the professionalism of the game. The MCC Marylebone Cricket Club, the custodian of the laws of the game, declared that no gentleman ought to make a profit by his service in the cricket field. The years following the Second World War brought a bit more impartiality into the world of cricket as the game transitioned into a player's game. The advent of professionalism and commercialism has turned the game into a global giant, but the nickname has remained. However, what was a term with referring to the British class system and Victorian idols has today morphed into a term signifying the spirit of the game.